lot smaller than the process time counts it. So if the characteristic time of your process is 60 minutes, you know, thermocouple had a time constant of a couple seconds. It's going to be way faster. Okay. If you start to get sensors or final control elements that are time constants approach the process time constant, it's going to be a problem. Because you can't measure and actuate fast enough, it limits your ability to do control. Okay. All right. So typically what we're going to assume, which is quite reasonable, is that there's no appreciable dynamics to this. You understand it does have some dynamics, but they're so fast compared to the process, we'll just pretend it has no dynamics. Like pseudo steady state assumptions. Okay, so let's do this one slide here and then we'll do that. Okay. So all I'm doing here is proving to you that you can represent a thermocouple, for example, as a transfer function that's first order. So to do this, I've done a material balance. I'm a little hungry right now. This would be an energy balance, okay? All right. So I did an energy balance on this well. So here's the way this works, a real thermocouple. Here's the fluid. It's probably flowing in most cases. Might be stagnant. You have a well, a thermocouple well. The thermocouple sits inside this thing because you don't want to put the thermocouple in the fluid itself. Right, so you put it in this well. So what has to happen to sense the temperature? You have to have heat transfer through this wall to the thermocouple to sense that. So obviously you don't want to make this thermal well out of an insulating material. Okay, be a bad idea. So you want high heat transfer here. So this is just an energy balance. So this is energy being transferred from the fluid. Let me see it again. From the fluid. To this well, and this one to the well to the measurement device. Okay. When did you guys take heat transfer last year? Yeah. You guys take heat transfer as a junior?
Yeah.
A little bit late, but okay. So you've got, this is a sidebar. Don't you agree our curriculum has almost no action the second year you're here? It's like you probably don't even know each other until you go to the third year of the curriculum. All right, so this is heat being transferred from the fluid into the thermal well and from the thermal well to the thermocouple. The difference between this is the accumulation of energy in the thermal well. So I've just done an energy balance on the thermal well saying the accumulation is the difference between the rate at which energy is transferred to the thermal well and taken away from the thermal well. That's all. Okay. So it's a nice linear differential equation. I can rearrange it like this. Just by dividing by UA and bringing up the TM over here. Why do I like this? Because this is the standard form of a first order differential equation, that thing we like to call tau. Okay. So I can equivalently come up with a transfer function. You're going to start seeing more and more of this. If I tell you, I found the transfer function of that, it's this. I just assume at this point you can do it. Like, the problems get more and more steps as we get more advanced. And I'm not going to show every step. So what did I do to find the transfer function of this thing? Guess what? I found a deviation model for the prime. I took a Laplace transform. I rearranged it for this thing over this thing. Okay? It's the same thing we always do. And you'd see you get something that looks like this. Okay? So, well, that looks like a first order transfer function with a gain of 1 and a time constant of that thing. So when you look at this, first of all, you're like, okay. What does this time constant tell me? We want this time constant to be small, right? So how can you make it small? We can make the numerator smaller, the denominator big. How can you do that? Have high heat transfer. That's going to make things be fast. Have high heat transfer area. Both these things make a lot of heat transfer, and therefore it makes it fast. Have a low capacitance, right? If this material that has a low heat capacity, that will also make it fast. And also if it's small, has a lot of small mass, okay? But in general, what we're gonna do, so this is a nice little bit of analysis, okay, fine. We're gonna make the following assumption that the relationship between the actual measurement, the actual value and the measurement has dynamics, but it's so fast that it's just gonna be a game, okay, for the calibration. Okay, so I'll see you guys tomorrow and we will do that last time.